Video 2 for handling of decimals. This one is for multiplication and division. We've got our problems. Now, unlike adding and subtracting, when I go to do this one and set it up vertically, I do line up off of the right, and I actually ignore the decimals for now. Here's where multiplication differs from adding and subtracting, and division is going to be a little different yet. But I ignore the decimals, and I'm going to actually handle this as if I'm multiplying 218 times 37. So it means when I multiply through, I'm going to multiply through first by the 7, and then I'm going to multiply through by the 3, and when I go to do the 3, I step over 1. So let's see how that works. 7 times 8 is 56. I write the 6. I carry the 5. 7 times 1 is 7 plus 5 is 12. I write the 2. Carry the 1. 7 times 2 is 14 plus 1 is 15. Last number, nowhere else to carry, write 15. All right, now I'm stepping over from 7 to 3, so I'm going to start writing under the 3. So 3 times 8 is 24. Carry the 4, carry the 2. 3 times 1 is 3, plus 2 is 5. Nothing to carry. 3 times 2 is 6. I'm done multiplying, so now I'm going to add down. 6 plus 0, remember that's actually an empty spot, so we placehold it, is 6. 2 plus 4 is 6. 5 plus 5 is 10. Carry the 1. 1 plus 1 is 2 plus 6 is 8. Now, here's where the decimals come into play. I now go back and count how many decimal places are in the original numbers. I see 1, 2. So there's 2 decimal places in the first one and only 1 in the second, for a total of 3 decimal places. So that means how many places from the right I'm going to count to the left to put in a decimal place. I'm going to count from the right side and move it in 3 places. So that's 1, 2, 3. So 2.18 times 3.7 is 8.066. That's multiplication. The difference again is, I keep stressing it, is that we line up off of the right when adding and subtracting, we line up off the decimal. All right, division. Division is different again. Now, be careful, this is one way you can see how it's written, or that's another way. Or now, here's where mistakes that I see with students, pitfalls. They'll be handed this problem and they go to rewrite this and they'll put the second number inside and the first number out. That is incorrect. First number goes in, second number goes out. The reason why a lot of students do that is because of how you key it into the calculator. So be careful. Now, calculators can divide by decimals. We can't. How we do it is that we have to get rid of the decimal. So we do it by moving the decimal. So if I move it 2 places here, this becomes 325. That means I have to move it 2 places inside also. What we do on the outside, we do on the inside. So this becomes 411.125. Next pitfall students do, they forget to move the decimal on the inside. I'm just telling you where most common mistakes happen. All right, so now we start our division. And don't feel bad if you have to do a little bit of side multiplication. Most students do. So 325 goes into 4, doesn't. 325 goes into 41. Nope, doesn't. 325 goes 411. Yes, one time. So that's where I start. Oops, almost started to do it. I subtract again. Remember, I sometimes have to borrow, like in this case, I have to borrow. So 11 minus 5 gives me 6. 0 minus 2, oh, got to borrow. So 10 minus 2 gives me 8. 3 minus 3 gives me 0. So that leaves me 86. And that is smaller than that, so I'm good. And that was a 1. All right, I'm going to drop the next number. And 325 goes in how many times? Well, this is where I said sometimes you get to do a little side work. So I'm betting it's twice. 2 times 5 is 10. Carry the 1. 2 times 2 is 4 plus 1 is 5. 6. 650. And that's by 2. Now, yes, I left a gap there. Well, remember, really, got to keep those decimals lined up. So now I subtract. 0 minus 1 is 1. 6 minus 5, or 1 minus 0. Sorry, I said it backwards. 6 minus 5 is 1. 8 minus 6 is 2. 2 11 smaller? Sure is. So I'm going to drop. Now, I did forget to add one thing. I want to talk about the previous one of the previous videos again about rounding. This one I wanted to put round to nearest tenth. Because I'm not sure how far I have to keep going until this comes out even. So we're not going to. You're getting the gist of the division. So, because we know that I'm rounding to the nearest tenth, I only need one more digit. Because it's this digit that tells me how to round this one. So, 2112 divided by 325. Well, I'm betting that's 6, because 6 times 3 is 18. That's kind of close. That's how I get it, guys. Just so you know, how to know where to start. It's a rounding. Another type of rounding trick. So 6 times 5 is 30. Carry the 3. 6 times 2 is 12 plus 3 is 15. Carry the 1. 6 times 3 is 18 plus 1 is 19. So 1950. Now, I could subtract, but I don't care. Because it says round to the nearest tenth. I need that digit to tell me how to round that digit. That's all I need it for. Any other digit after that, if I continue on, is considered unnecessary. So the 6 tells me the 2 rounds up. So my final answer is 1.3. Because the 6 says the 2 rounds up. Well, this is it for multiplication and division. I hope that helped. If you need to practice it, there is a worksheet for decimals after this video. It does include the answers plus the work. So if you thought, man, where did I go wrong? You can actually see these worked out. Good luck.